it goes back to the same point. I think the recommendation is that usually CISO technology in the Middle East is always disconnected from top management. You have to link that. You have to show that the business continuity, which is related to the risk management, which related to sustainability and continuity and the growth of the business, is all together. So this is the most important. It's not a technology. It's about the business. So we want to make sure the business continue and grow. And this is where he can get his money and he gets his support to make whatever he wants.
My advice to CISOs in UAE is that, first of all, you know, to ensure that IT security, you know, is given its place, you know, in the top management. We need to tie the IT security to the company's strategy. We need to ensure that we have the right training and skilled people in the organization. Need to invest in the technology and, for example, in threat intelligence, etc. So, build a total type of awareness within the organization that what impact IT security or, you know, IT has on basically the business of the organization.
My advice to the CISOs of UAE is primarily, first you plan based on your business. That means first you understand where you are, then start engaging with MSSP, that it can be a long-term engagement, it is not a short-term engagement, that what you achieve in 1 year, what you achieve in this 2 years, 3-5 years plan. And I'll not recommend to go for a more than 5 year plan, because after 5 years, what will happen, the technology will go, you don't even know. Now that's why my suggestion to the CISOs of UAE to understand where they are today and work with some expert MSSP organization, managed security service providers, and find out which portion they can give it to MSSP with right SLS and KPIs, and which portion they will be able to maintain in-house. And slowly, they have to create some SLO within the organization, service level objectives, and then it can be defined with an SLA with a MSSP.
What I would advise CISOs is what I do myself, which is continuously learn. You know, we can't, like, I have a whole number of certification, but that's not enough. We have to learn things daily, because there are so many outcomes, there's so many outbreaks, so many new things coming out there. So I learn everything. I make a point, I'm just spending half an hour to an hour daily. Maybe it could be just reading. Sometimes it'll be listening to podcasts. I mean, there are so many ways of gathering information. So I would advise CISOs to learn continuously, look what's happening. Network with peers, because, you know, we can only do so much as alone, but as a network, as a group, we can learn much more from each other.
Well, sir, my advice that you always live another day to learn more stuff that about how to address the challenges that we are facing, and there is no way we can stop seeking out new information and help, because we are always to be discovering new stuff that we didn't even know that these threats exist.
As a CISO, actually the position is a little bit tricky, because it depends how you come to the company and to who you will report to. For the CISO who are reporting directly to the managing director, they have to work with operation people, IT people. That means they have to be their advice. If they don't advise the existing resources within the organization in order to embrace security, they will get difficulties. It's better for them to become like advisor, mentor for security within the organization than pinpointing policies and try to apply these policies by any means.